Doc.
Hello, Rimfire. Doesn't the Navy ever run out of potatoes?
This ship sure don't.
Evening, Doctor.
Ellis, Johnny.
Evening, sir.
Hot below.
Sure is. I'm going to sleep topside tonight myself.
It won't for long. We're getting a tail end of a storm in the mid-watch.
A man can't plan too much ahead at all, can he?
Not much.
All right, you guys. Come on, break it up. Make room for a working sailor.
Just keep working, man. Just keep working.
Listen, you're lucky you don't get it on your heads. Come and get it, you hungry buzzards! Here's another one! Who's gonna light?
Ah, those sharks.
Ain't they nasty things?
They're just fish.
Hey, Corky. What do you think about the captain they sent to take old Pinky's place?
I ain't supposed to think.
You know something? He ain't left the sea cabin since we left Trinidad this morning.
What's he doing? Playing AC Doocy by himself or something?
I'll tell you what he's doing.
He's seasick. That's what he's doing. That's what the Navy's coming to. They got seasick feather merchants taking a place of bringing a Navy like Captain Pinky. Well, man, I just hope this guy knows port from starboard. That's all I hope.
You know what I'd do if I was you, Robbins? I'd just put in for the skipper's job if I was you. The skipper.
All right. Did you have your laugh?
Well, now I'm gonna tell you something. The guy who walks that bridge has got your neck in his hands, and don't you forget it.
Thanks, Salvador. You've got us down 200, partner.
Sorry, sir.
Six spades.
I thought I could do it, sir.
Well, don't go off half-cocked again.
No, sir.
Any sign of the weather yet, Doc?
Kind of filling up in the east.
Oh, jolly, jolly. And I've got the watch.
I pass.
What do you mean you pass? Haven't you got anything?
Why don't you just look at his hand?
Well, I have to help him along.
I suppose I could try a heart, sir.
He supposes he could try a heart, sir.
Two clubs. Captain Morrell still hold up, Doc?
As far as I know.
Three diamonds. They might have sent us a captain who had his sea legs under him.
I guess they do the best they can.
Well, I still don't see why they didn't move Ware up. He's been exec long enough.
My dear Mackeson, the only craft I've ever commanded was a yawl in the Miami yacht races. And the nearest I ever came to winning that was 29th. The Navy may have been desperate enough to put me in uniform, but not foolish enough to let me sail away by myself. Beats me how I ever got this far up the ladder.
Money. Oh, I know you, rich boy.
Oh, don't be bitter, Grandpa. Your bid, Maxon.
Four spades.
I'm not bitter. I just want to go home. When I bought that ranch in Nevada, I never expected to see water again. Ensign Mary.
Sir?
Your bid. Careful.
Yes, sir. I'm thinking about it.
Your mouth's open, Ensign.
Sir?
Are you going to bid?
Six diamonds.
Six diamonds?
I'm just backing you up, sir.
Ware, you are deliberately distracting my partner.
Pass and double.
All right, Mr. Mary. Dummy.
This Morrell seems like a cold sort of a fish.
Captain Morrell oughtn't to be here at all. He's as weak as a kitten. A man who gets his ship torpedoed and spends 25 days on a raft in the North Atlantic oughtn't have to hit the ball again with only a few weeks in the hospital. I guess there aren't enough commanding officers to go around. Well, at least they gave him an easy ship.
Boy, easy's no word for it. Listen, he'll get more rest on this boat.
Ship.
Ship, boat. What's the difference? He'll still get more rest here than he would if he were in a feather bed. Now, me, I'd like something to happen once in a while.
If the Navy ever gets a load of this salty crew in battle, they'll send us all back to boot camp. I look so ridiculous with my head shaved.
Kid, couldn't you have indicated clubs? Then I could have gone to no trump. We are going down again. And doubled.
Sorry, sir. All right.
Your lead, Magazine.
Now hear this. Lay before the mast, all 8 o'clock reports. Darkened ship. The smoking lamp is out on all weather decks.
Slow it down a little.
All engines ahead, 2/3.
Bridge, radar. I've got a spook.
Radar contact, Mr. Ware.
What?
Radar contact.
Good heavens.
Bridge, I...
Definite spook, sir.
Storm enough to plot?
Range 12,000 off the starboard bow.
Get on the plot, Magazine.
Captain, I...
Radar reports a contact off starboard bow, sir.
Run a plot on it.
Plot's working, sir.
Then head for the target.
Aye, aye, sir. Zigzag, sir?
What would you say, mister?
Me? Well, negative zigzag, sir. Give the plot a chance to steady on.
That's right, mister.
Get that again, radar.
You got it?
Estimated target's course 140. Speed 10 knots. Bearing 124 true.
Bring her around a 124. All engines ahead, flank.
124, sir.
All engines ahead, flank, sir.
Can't seem to make up his mind, can he?
Maybe he wants to see if I'm awake down there.
Juicing it up for him.
Hey, buddy, what's the word?
Radar's got something on the screen. We're going after it.
What's up, Clark?
Come on, Dave. He says they got a bogey.
Hurry. Yeah, hurry, come on, wake up. Radar's got
something. Going after
you don't want to miss it, do you?
Gangway, please.
I was here first. Gangway yourself. Excuse me, sir. Hey, break it up. Let the captain in.
What's all the crowd about, sailor?
Well, sir, I guess we don't get much excitement aboard this ship.
Now, keep your seat. What's your name?
Andrews, sir.
Well, what do you make of it, Andrews?
I don't exactly know, Captain. Our speed's kind of rattling the set.
Well, take a guess. You're the operator.
Well, sir, it's knocking down about 10 knots. It's got some power, but it's too small a spook to be a heavy vessel. I'd say it might be a fishing smack, or... Well, it might be the conning tower of a sub, sir.
Bridge, Lieutenant Ware.
Mr. Ware, we're about to lose radar contact at the rate we're hitting the sea. Reduce speed to speed of target and get on its tail. At this distance, we ought to make visual contact at daybreak.
Shall I shake the ship out for a standby?
Well, there isn't much shaking out to be done down here, but ready underwater search gear. If this spook is a U-boat, he might pull the plug and we'll have to go after him. Who's the senior radarman, Andrews?
That's me, sir.
All right, then you'll have to track the target for us. Any turn he makes, any change in speed, no matter how small, don't you miss one move.
I'll stick on him. Don't you worry, Captain.
All right, I won't. Anybody's going to be caught with his pants down, it oughtn't to be us.
Seems like he knows his business to me.
Feather merchant, that's all I got to say. Feather merchant.
Singer ist zu Stern, Herr Kapitän. 8,000 meters.
It's either ship or false echo.
You lost it?
Yeah, Captain. It comes and goes. The sea return makes it difficult to keep the image. There, Captain. There it comes.
Port 20 degrees, Ruffin.
Port 20 degrees.
Port 20 degrees. Port 20.
Target's course changing to port.
Target's on left, Captain. 25, 20 degrees.
Maintain your present speed. Steady as you go.
Steady as you go.
Steady as you go, sir.
May I ask what your procedure is, sir?
Well, if this is an enemy ship, he may have our signal on his oscillator, and he's trying to feel us out. Take a couple of turns, see if we change position. If we can hold an unchanging position behind him, he might mistake us for a ghost echo in these heavy seas.
The signal does not change, sir, Captain.
Starboard 40 degrees.
Starboard 40 degrees.
Starboard 40 degrees.
Starboard 40.
Target's turning sharp starboard, sir. Can you estimate the degree, Andrews? Oh. 40. 45 degrees, Captain.
All engines stop.
All engines stop.
All engines stop, sir.
You, think it might be a U-boat, sir?
Wiggling like one. He may take the bait. If he doesn't, he'll crash dive.
Excuse me, sir.
It holds the same place, sir, Captain.
Mm-hmm. Your zoom calls 140.
140.
140.
Yes. He's on the hook, Captain. He's coming back to course 140.
All engines ahead, two-thirds, sir. 140.
Aye, aye, sir. 140.
All engines ahead, two-thirds, sir.
Well done, Andrews. But the target won't be satisfied with that one check on us. Now look for him to make a turn every now and then. Or he may slow down or speed up. Thank you.
Sir?
Well?
Do you want to send a dispatch, sir?
Why? Are you anxious to take one, sailor?
Oh, no, sir. I just thought maybe...
We have to keep radio silence tonight, sailor. He might tip our hand to the target. But I'll get one off the fleet operations in the morning, okay?
Yes, sir.
This is the captain. I guess you're all waiting for some kind of word.
We're tracking an unidentified ship. We're going to try to stay on his tail until morning. We will breakfast early and go to battle stations at 0530. Don't be surprised if we tangle with a pig boat a little after dawn. Do your jobs efficiently. We'll chalk one up for the Hanes. That's all.
I reckon we'll just drop an egg right down his periscope. That'll be the end of one more Nazi, huh?
Or he'll just pop a fish right in our guts, and that'll be the end of this tin can.
Man, a sub ain't no match for us.
Oh, they ain't, huh? Then how come they hunt U-boats with three destroyers working together up in the North Atlantic?
Yeah, how come?
Your bet.
Who's watches next?
Lieutenant Kunze, Captain.
Have him come here.
You're right, Captain. Lieutenant Kunze, report forward.
You wanted me, Herr Captain?
Yeah, Kunze. Yours is the next watch on topside.
You have a signal on the FMB. I think it's a false echo. But to check its reaction, you will zigzag twice an hour until daybreak. If it moves in closer, you will awaken me immediately.
Jawohl, Herr Kapitän.
Schwaffer.
Come in, Heini. Ah, that Kunz annoys me. Remind him that we do not salute at sea.
He's new, Herr Kapitän. He will tire of it.
He's new, Like our new Germany. A machine.
Herr Kapitän, you think we are wise in risking that image to be a false echo?
Wise? Expedient?
Time is important, Heine, and we would travel too slowly underwater. In 48 hours, we rendezvous with Radar M. We take the captured British codebook, and we go home with it. And this is the important thing, not the codebook, but because when we have it, we can go home. Auf den Wohl.
Zum Wohle, Kapitän.
Ah, tastes like oil and bilge and green mold. Sit down, Heine.
Tastes like a U-boat. I've been in the U-boats too long, Heine. There was a time when I went to sea with a fresh heart, but that was many years ago. Now I can only think of going home. You want more?
No more, Herr Kapitän.
You think I take too much? Just enough to sleep. I cannot rest without it. I think too much. Never think, Heine. Be a good warrior and never think. You pay penalty for thinking. You cannot rest. I taught these sons of men to be good warriors. Country, duty, ask no question. One is at the bottom of the sea. This one is a cinder in a burned airplane. And I'm glad. That's the way for warriors to die, young and with faith. I've lived too long. Your friends, Heine?
I've been with you since I was a cadet.
That's not what I asked you.
I do not know. Sometimes I'm afraid of you. Many times I do not understand you. I'm not certain we are friends.
We are friends, Heine. Believe that. We are friends. Because we are friends, I tell you something. I'm sick of this war. It's not a good war. You don't remember the first one? I was a Fähnrich in the U-boats, and how proud I was. We went out in those little sardine tins, and if we submerged, we couldn't always be sure we'd come up again. Oh, it was a good game we played. The captain would look through his periscope and sight a target, and then he did arithmetic in his head and said, "Torpedo loss!" And you know something? Sometimes the torpedo wouldn't even leave the tube. And if it did, we were most lucky to hit something. Now I look in the periscope and it gives me the distance and the speed. I pass this information to the attack table, and the machinery turns and the lights flash, and we get the answer. The torpedo runs to its target, and there's no human error in this. They've taken human error out of war, Heine. They've taken the human out of war. War was different then. Put iron in the country's backbone, gave them brave memory. And even in defeat, it gave them honor. But there's no honor in this war. Memories will be ugly, even if we win. And if we die without God. You know that, honey?
I listen to what you say, Herr Kapitän.
It's a bad war. Its reason is twisted. Its purpose is dark. It's not for a simple man.
Lieutenant Crane coming up, sir. Port side.
Mr. Crane, what's your best time on reloading depth charges?
It's not so hot, Captain. Some of my boys are pretty green, but I'd say, 3 minutes or four.
Well, you've got to do better than that.
I can try, sir.
That's not good enough. Might be the difference between stopping the enemy and getting stopped ourselves.
Well, if that's the case, sir, we'll be good enough.
I'll depend on it. Mr. Ware, I'd like you to stick with the plot in the pilot house for the time being, if you will, please.
Aye, aye, sir.
Like we've run out of the squall.
Yep.
Captain, why don't you lay in your cabin for a while?
No, I'm all right, Doctor.
You getting the feel of a ship again?
Either that or that pig boat out there is strong medicine.
I don't see how you can know it's the enemy.
Well, call it a sixth sense if you want to. I always seem to know when there's a mine working the other end of that radar beam.
Interesting. You know, I've heard hunters say the same thing. They can sense the presence of game. Well, in any case, this is going to be a disappointed ship if it isn't the enemy.
Yes, you all seem to be a bloodthirsty crew.
Well, the men would like a chance to do what they're here for. Not much other reason for existence, not now, anyway.
No, I sometimes wonder if there ever was another reason.
I know what you mean. I had a baby clinic up in Ohio. It's pretty important to me. Now it seems like something had happened on another planet in another century. What was your work, Captain?
This, see?
Mean you were a sailor?
I was third officer on a freighter out of Boston to Liverpool, Le Havre, and back again.
Some of our crew will be glad to know that. Our saltiest boys were complaining mightily about getting a civilian skipper. Feather merchant, I think they call it.
Well, I am a feather merchant.
Well, yes, but not exactly.
No, exactly. On the freighter, we were men against the sea. Here, we're men against men. Like every other civilian in the war, I had to learn a new way of thinking.
Why did you change over to the Navy?
Well, the freighter I was on was cut in half by a torpedo. I thought I'd like to be on the shooting end for a change.
Captain.
Captain, aye.
Target's increased speed to 13 knots, sir.
Bring up a compensating speed, Mr. Ware.
Aye, aye, sir. All engines ahead standard, 203 RPM, sir.
Very well.
Well, in time, we'll all get back to our own stuff again. The war will get swallowed up and seem like it never happened.
Yes, but it won't be the same as it was. We won't have that feeling of permanency that we had before. We've learned a hard truth.
How do you mean?
That there's no end to misery and destruction. You cut the head off the snake and it grows another one. You cut that one off and you find another. We can't kill it because it's something within ourselves. You can call it the enemy if you want to, but it's part of us. We're all men.
I suppose there is some reason to lose hope, but, you know, I reject it because I have a family. And I want something better for them than war, and I think it's possible. You any children, Captain?
No.
Married?
I married a girl in England. She was killed.
Bombers?
No, when the war broke out, I got passage for her on my freighter for home. The one that was torpedoed in half. I was aft when it happened. I watched the other half of the ship just slide away. There wasn't anything I could do about it. I saw her run out on the foredeck, and I heard her call my name, and then that half of the ship just turned over and went down. We hadn't been married very long. Bring up the fire room. Tell them we're making smoke. I don't want to see that at dawn.
Aye, aye, sir.
You've got more reason than the rest of us to want to catch this submarine ahead. It might be the one that...
Oh, it might be, but this isn't my private war, Doctor. I'm just doing what I have to do, like that German captain out there. I don't like the job, but maybe he doesn't either.
Weather for free weather control, sir.
Thank you. Oh, we're moving into a high pressure area. Going to have a clear day.
Set ASW condition 1. All hands man your battle stations.
Repair parties, manned and ready. Condition able, set.
Quartermaster First, Quiroga, at the helm, sir.
Quartermaster Second, Spencer, on annunciator, sir.
Engineering spaces manned and ready. All boilers on the line. Maximum speed available, 24 knots.
Lewis, sonar. Sonar gear manned and ready.
Magazines manned and ready.
Sky 1 mount, 33, manned and ready.
Sky 1 mount, 32 reporting, manned and ready, sir.
1241, manned and ready.
Sky 1 mount, 31, manned and ready.
All guns manned and ready.
Very well. Ship is smart and quick, Mr. Ware.
Thank you, sir. We've got a willing bunch of boys.
Messenger. When that U-boat pulls the plug, code this dispatch for fleet operation.
Aye, aye, sir.
Have tracked U-boat 130 miles bearing 140. Now engaging enemy. Give our grid position. All right, let's get after the target. Mr. Mary, ring up flank speed.
All engines ahead, flank.
Ready, sir.
We might get close enough to get a shot at him before he pops under.
Chip of stern, Herr Schwaffer.
Alarm!
Degrees rudder. Steady up on 170. Slow to 2/3 speed.
Slow to 2/3 speed, sir?
It's not necessary to repeat the order, Quartermaster.
Aye, aye, sir.
Zigzag, sir?
Negative zigzag.
Aye, aye, sir.
170 at 10 knots. We're sitting ducked, that's what we are.
Sending our beam to the enemy, sir?
Yes, I'm giving him a free shot at us with the stern tubes. You can't reload those tubes very well. We can attack up his tail whenever we want to.
Yes, sir. But how do we know when he's firing, sir?
I'll give him 5 minutes to get to emergency depth, another 3 to come back up to periscope depth, another 2 minutes to get us in his sights. If he's any kind of a captain, he'll spit the fish out 10 minutes from now.
Level. Seal.
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 Engine room clear. Robot torpedo room clear. After torpedo room clear.
You were all ready for action. Men at their stations.
Silent routine.
Silent routine.
Silent routine.
Silent routine.
He's crossing our stern to starboard, Herr Kapitän. He does not approach. I do not understand, Herr Kapitän. He doesn't zigzag and he holds course away from us.
Give them to me. He's clever or he's a fool. Maybe he's too clever or too foolish. Or is seen.
Bring the ship up to periscope depth.
Periscope depth!
American escort destroyer.
Escort destroyer.
One stack.
One stack.
3-inch guns fore and aft.
3-inch guns fore and aft.
Anti-aircraft midships. No tubes.
Midships. No tubes.
Buckley class destroyer escort, turbo electric, maximum speed 25 knots, carries stern racks and K guns. Capable of dropping 17 patterns, carries latest underwater detection gear.
I think we use the stern tubes. Ready stern tubes for underwater attack.
Ja, vor, Herr Kapitän. Ready stern tubes for underwater attack.
Target red 90.
Red 90.
Range 1,000.
1,000.
Torpedo speed 30 knots.
Speed red 90, 1,000, speed knots. 30.
Fire position 6 degrees. Torpedo deflection 10. Running speed 30. Depth 2 meters. Fire both torpedoes.
On. On. Yeah. On. Mm-hmm. On. 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 Yeah. On. Standing by.
Port 6 degrees.
Firing position, Air Captain.
Torpedoes ready?
Torpedoes ready.
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 Count.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Torpedoes, los!
Torpedoes running.
Torpedoes running.
Running time?
1 minute, 40 seconds, Herr Kapitän.
Thank you.
propellers coming in from port side.
High speed propellers, port side.
Stop port engine, starboard engine ahead full.
Stop port engine, starboard engine ahead full.
Torpedoes on the port bow.
All ahead standard, stop your swing and steady up.
All ahead standard, stop your swing and steady up.
Races were never like this.
Hey, Corky, how do you suppose the captain knew when to turn this old tub?
Because he's a captain, and that's the reason he is and you ain't.
All right, let's go get it.
Yes, sir.
All engines ahead full, ring up 18 knots, steady as she goes.
All engines ahead full, ring up 18 knots, steady as she goes.
Aye, aye, sir.
To 100, emergency.
Emergency
100. Steer
140.
140.
140. I do not see how we could have missed at that range.
We shouldn't have. I think this American captain is no amateur.
Well, neither am I.
Sonar captain, commence underwater search. Make sure it's piped through under the bridge speaker.
Aye, sir. Lowering sonar projector.
Sonar searching beam to beam, sir.
Who's on sonar, Mr. Ware?
Lewis, sir. He's good at the job.
That's him!
Got him, sir.
Keep it open.
Target's still on the old course of 140, Captain.
We'll try to cross 140 when we come astern of him.
Sonar, Lasher, Captain. He has made contact. Do you wish to change course?
No, not yet. We wait until he thinks he has our depth.
We're going to be on him pretty quickly, sir.
Depth charge 41. Depth setting, sir.
Set to 75. But I'm able to order that before we fire.
Set pattern for 75.
Set pattern for 75.
Set for 75. Set for 75.
Set the pattern for 75.
Set for 75. Set for 75.
Set.
Load. Loaded.
Range 500, closing fast.
Range 500, closing fast.
$300, sir.
Pattern set to 75, sir.
Stand by to fire.
Stand by.
Stand by!
Stand by the fire!
Port 33.
Port 33.
Down to 150.
150.
150.
It's going deeper. Mr. Ware, reset depth charges to 150.
Aye, aye, sir.
Reset at 150.
Reset at 150.
Reset to 150. Repeat. Reset to 150.
Secure it. Fire one.
Fire one!
Fire two.
Sonar, Captain. He's using some kind of a decoy. Can you pick him out of it?
He's coming out of it now, sir. Heading about 080 degrees.
Left 10 degrees, rudder.
Left 10 degrees, rudder.
Reset depth charge pattern to 150.
Reset depth charge pattern to 150.
Increase rudder to 30 degrees left. Steady up on 080.
Increase rudder to 30 degrees left. Steady up on 080.
Reverse course and take it up to 50.
Reverse course up to 50.
50!
Course reversed.
I've lost contact.
Lewis can't find him, sir.
Secure underwater search. Reduce speed to two-thirds.
Secure underwater search. Reduce speed to two-thirds.
Mr. Mackeson, we're going to give you a hypothetical problem.
Aye, Captain.
Take our last contact with the target as a starting point.
Our course was 164, sir.
Give the target a course of 260. Keep him on it for 30 minutes at a speed of 4 knots.
260, 30 minutes, 4 knots.
And bring him back on course 140 for 30 minutes at a speed of 8 knots.
140, 30 minutes, 8 knots.
We'll hold our present course and speed for half an hour.
30 at 18.
Now, from wherever we are at the end of that time, give me a course and speed to intercept the target.
Aren't we going
to
make a lost contact search, Captain?
We won't catch this bird in a search pattern. I'm pretty sure he's dusted off our keel and scooted in the opposite direction.
Our course would be 239 degrees, speed 19 knots. We would intercept in 28 minutes from the beginning of the run, sir.
All right, we'll try it.
The target might not come back on course 140, sir.
No, I think he will.
He's got an important mission. Nothing's going to stop him short of being sunk. Pass the word to battle station stand easy.
Aye, sir.
He fades, Capitaine. He goes away.
You think he's given up, Capitaine?
It's possible. But to be certain, we hold this course for a while before we turn again to 140.
Captain, sir?
Well?
How are we doing?
You're doing all right, sailors.
That guy Robbins is 180 out. This guy ain't no feather merchant.
You said it.
I had to amputate his fingers.
What was your time on reloading, Mr. Green?
3 minutes, 3 the first time, 2 minutes, 40 the second, sir.
Right on. Give your crew a well done for me.
Thank you, sir.
Well, lie still, sailor. You're out of the war now.
Is it bad?
You've lost your fingers. It's my fault. I shouldn't have tripped those racks so quickly.
No, sir. I oughtn't to have had my hand on the rail. I guess I got excited, sir.
Well, we'll get you flown stateside as soon as we put back into Trinidad. You'll be back in your civvy job in no time at all.
I was a watchmaker.
Operational priority dispatch coming in, sir.
Ask the executive officer to join me in the crypto room.
Yes, sir.
Well, you won't be making any watches again.
No, sir. I'll make out all right.
I'd bet on that. All right, let's get him to bed.
Did we get the sub, sir?
No, we missed him.
I'd have given my fingers to get that sub.
I don't pretend to know anything about sub chasing, Ellis, but I'd rather think our new captain does. Joe, that U-boat is still in the ocean. I wouldn't give a plugged duck for its chances.
Dispatch is just coming through the Dakota, sir.
Destroyers Luckman, Wall, Green, detached to aid you. Anticipate U-boat may be attempting to rendezvous with German radar S, U, or M. Reduce radio traffic to position signal once every hour. End.
But it'll take 14 or 15 hours for the destroyers to catch up with us, Captain.
Yes, if we're lucky enough to tie onto that U-boat again, he may tow us up against a raider before help comes. That wouldn't be so lucky, would it? Those murdering wolves can outgun and outrun us. How do you feel about it, Mr. Ware?
We're closing the triangle in 14 minutes, sir.
Well?
Let's push our luck.
Alert battle stations, Mr. Ware.
Aye, aye, sir.
Voltage is low on power generator.
I'll call the LE.
Hmm?
More soup, Herr Kapitän?
Huh?
More power on the port generator.
It does not taste like tennis shoes, Herr Kapitän.
It's very good. The man mistreat you, Cookie.
They make jokes when they are happy. I don't mind.
Are they happy now?
They are proud of you, Herr Kapitän.
Thank you, Cookie.
It's now nearly 50 minutes, Herr Kapitän.
Yeah. Kunz!
Ja, Herr Kapitän.
Bring the ship up to periscope depths.
Jawohl, Herr Kapitän. Herr Kapitän, the maneuvers were brilliant, Herr Kapitän. The Führer would be pleased.
Herr Kapitän.
Huh?
Propellers, 1,200 meters.
Which quarter?
Port quarter, Herr Kapitän.
18 meters, Herr Kapitän.
Be ready for emergency dive.
Stand by, emergency dive.
Emergency, down to 80.
80, down to 80.
The American has read my mind, Heine.
Yeah.
Portrait 3, down to 150.
Portrait 3, 150.
150.
Portrait 3.
Target turning left, sir.
Left, standard rudder. Set depth charges to 150.
Set depth charges to 150.
Left, standard rudder.
Plateau, Kapitän. But 310 meters. It's not possible, Kapitän, to go that deep. Pressure would crush the hull.
Portrait 3, release bolt.
Portrait 3,
release bolt.
Portrait 3.
The bottom.
Herr Kapitän.
Bottom.
Jawohl, Captain. Bottom.
Stop engines.
He's given me the slip again. I'm not getting anything but bottom echoes.
Sonar's lost him, Captain.
Give me a fathometer reading.
150 fathoms, sir.
There's 310 meters. It's over 1,000 feet.
Can he go that deep?
He might like us to think he can't. Slow down turbines easy until stopped.
Slow down turbines easy until stopped.
I want absolute silence on this ship. Sonar, this is the captain. Secure, but keep a close listening watch on the hydrophone. If he is down there, I don't think he'll have time to linger very long.
His engines are fading.
He's not cycling?
9. He's gone, Herr Kapitän.
We will listen for a while.
Doc, this is really a hot one. At least they're keeping cool down there. You can say that for them.
A painted ship on a painted ocean.
What's that, Doc?
I was reminded of the Ancient Mariner. You know, it rather fits us right now. Something unreal about this waiting out here on a deserted sea.
Well, it'll be real enough if that pig boat puts a fish in us. Any luck, Rimfire?
No, sir. Them fish afraid to make some noise if they bite.
Here, let me try it.
I guess you're finding his son kind of hard to take after the North Atlantic.
Oh, it doesn't matter. It's always either too cold or too hot, wherever there's a war on.
Well, I have a salt pill.
Thanks.
We've been floating around for quite a while. Don't think there's any chance the U-boat's gotten away from us again, do you?
Oh, he's down there all right.
Beats me how they get men to do it.
Do what?
Go and sit in that coffin down there.
Oh, they're not so bad off.
Actually, they stand a better chance than we do in this case. Pretty hard for one ship to surprise them. Their commander might be able to knock us off if he's smart enough.
You think he is?
What, smart enough? We'll know that when it happens.
I wonder what sort of man he is.
Well, he's got his share of guts, I know that. If he weren't so bullheaded about coming back on course 140, he could have kissed us goodbye a long time ago. That's all I know. I have no idea what he is or what he thinks. I don't want to know the men I'm trying to destroy.
Herr Kapitän.
Hmm? Yes, I know.
The American must be far away by this time.
It's a curious thing. But I know he's there, waiting. All right, we go. Silent routine, 140.
Level.
Level.
Course will be 140.
140.
Continue silent routine.
Sonar.
Go ahead, sonar. Propeller cavitation, deep and slow.
Can he pick up a heading?
Can you figure a heading? Lewis thinks he's moving southeast.
Coming back on 140 again. Alert battle station.
Alert battle station.
Commence underwater search.
Commence underwater search.
Give me minimum RPM on both shafts. Steer 140.
Propeller, Sir Captain.
He's a devil, Annie. Somehow we must lose him.
Plot has been pinpointed, sir.
Ready to close in, sir?
No, pass the word. I want a conference with all officers and chiefs. Make it in the warden.
Close is made. Pass the word. All officers and chiefs in the wardroom on the double.
We're at a disadvantage because he can turn sharper than we can. We can shake him up, but a death blow would be pure luck. We've expended a third of our depth charges. The U-boat can stay underwater for another 24 hours if he wants to. If we run out of depth charges, the offensive will have changed hands and we'd have to break contact to get away from his torpedoes. On the other hand, we just can't follow him and wait for our ships to join us because we might get pulled into a trap with a German raider before they get here. What we're going to do is to fight sort of a delaying action. Enemy's about 1,000 yards ahead. And we'll hold this distance for a little while. And we'll run in, lay one pattern of charges, drop back, wait for 1 hour, then attack again. We can keep this routine up for 7 hours. He can't get anywhere very fast, and our ship should be here by the end of that period. He might even surface. Being inside a submarine under attack is the worst experience you can imagine. After they get on to what we're doing, they might prefer to come up and surrender, or at least shoot it out with us. I want you all to get as much rest as you can. Stand easy at your stations, but be ready every time we lunge. It's going to be a long, dull job, but it's a damn sight worse for the Germans. We'll begin the routine at 1500.
Thank you.
Herr Kapitän!
Auf der Torpedo-Room! Wir haben Trouble hier!
Take command.
Sir.
Stay away from me! Stay away!
We can do nothing with him, Herr Kapitän.
Come here, son. Come here. Give me the wrench. Give it to me. You will come to attention. It's a part of our work to die. But we are not going to die. Do you believe me? Do you believe me?
He gets more, I can attack, Captain. He will tear us apart the next time.
What do you suggest, Kunz?
Surface, Herr Captain. Surrender.
Hold him.
I'm not concerned, Herr Captain.
Schwaffer?
I say go on.
Ali, what's the condition of the ship?
We've not yet been hurt.
But we cannot escape.
It would be your privilege to die for the new Germany. Put this on the ship's turntable.
The sound will carry, Herr Kapitän. It will help the American to know our position.
Put it on.
Herr Kapitän, you cannot do this.
Sing it, Heini! My friend, and you, my singer, Tiny.
But together, here's a toast to life and to laughter and song. Good beer, my friend. Good
sing it, Kunz. Sing it, all of them. Sing it, everybody.
Make the welkin ring as we sing loud and strong.
Fill up the flowing steins again with foam on every lip. We'll give its call and shout, yellow in lasting fellowship. And when we eye along the line, we pass the waiting ways. May we drink to love all our live long days.
To you, my friend, and you, my friend, and all of us together, here's a toast to life and to laughter and song. Good cheer, my friend, every kind of weather. Make your welkin ring as we sing loud and strong. Fill up the flowing steins again with foam on every lip. We'll keep us going and shout your lasting fellowship.
Sonar, I'm getting screwy noises from the hydrophone.
Sonar reports screwy noises from the target, sir.
Tell him to cut it in on speaker, Ensign.
Put it on the line, Lewis.
And when we hide and low and die with captivating waves.
They're having a ball down there. I don't think our psychology is working, Captain.
No, it's working all right.
I almost wish it wasn't.
All ahead for attack, Mr. Ware. Maybe we can rip him open in the middle of a waltz. Turning?
Sorry, sir. He doesn't seem to be a bit dead. He's going away at a good clip to starboard.
Right 10-degree rudder.
Right 10-degree rudder.
Stand by to fire, sir?
No, we'll ride his tail again. Let him digest that last one for a while. He can't stay down there much longer.
Come back on 140.
140.
140.
Schwaffer.
Yeah?
Ask Brown which way the American turned after the attack.
Come on.
Turn to starboard, Herr Kapitän.
Uh-huh. Now I will show you something. Each time he has attacked, we have turned off to port or starboard to avoid the attack. He drops his Wasser bombs and runs on for 300 or 400 meters and then turns to fall back on our stern. He doesn't always turn the same way, but twice he did. To run parallel with our course, for a very few minutes. In those minutes, he was vulnerable. If he does it again, we will be ready. There will not be time to come up to periscope depth, but it's possible. If we spread the four bow torpedoes, fired all at once, angled a few degrees apart, one may hit. One will be enough.
But if he does not turn parallel to our course, what can we do?
We will survive until he does.
Weather from Fleet Weather Control, sir.
Mr. Ware.
Yes, sir.
The weather's going to get worse before dawn. There's some wind in. It's going to be difficult to keep a fix on the target in the heavy sea. We may as well try to finish him off if we can.
Immediately?
Immediately. You inform Mr. Grain we'll be throwing everything we have left at the target.
You understand?
Herr Kapitän, the destroyer is closing.
Oh, he comes early.
We are ready, Herr Kapitän.
You understand there will not be the usual routine?
Jawohl, Herr Kapitän.
Seal torpedo.
Seal.
Mr. Ware, set depth charges to 100.
Aye, aye, sir.
Target turning to port, sir.
Stand by to fire.
Left 10 degrees, rudder.
Left 10 degrees, fire.
Fire!
Too shallow. Up to 50.
50!
50!
Now, American, turn the right way, and I'll give you a pretty present.
Claude reports he's off our stern. Course still 140.
Give a right 15-degree rudder. We'll make a beam attack.
Right 15-degree rudder.
He's turning.
Starboard 20 degrees.
Starboard 20.
Starboard 20.
Hold course.
Hold course.
Torpedoes. Los.
Los.
Go ahead, sonar. High-speed propeller effect, all on starboard side.
Stop, horn engine, left full rudder.
Can the pumps keep us afloat?
Well, if they can, it won't be for long.
We'll make it as long as you can. After engine, what's your damage?
We got a few valves loose. We're taking a little water. But we're still getting steam from number 2 fire room.
How long before you flood out?
30 minutes, maybe a little more.
Then stop your engines, but be ready to give me all the power you've got left the instant I ask for it. Mr. Ware, get yourself a party and go light several fires on deck. Use mattresses and gasoline.
I want
it to look as if the ship is burning.
The pumps have gotten into operation, but damage control says it's hopeless.
I'm sure it is. You go along with Ware and see if you can give him a hand. Radio, this is the captain. Send us emergency dispatch to operation. Hit by torpedo, request immediate assistance. That's all.
Engines have stopped.
We'll go up to periscope depth.
Periscope depth!
80 meters.
That's enough! Get out of here!
Attention, everyone. This is the captain. I want all of you to listen carefully.
The big boat got one in where it would do the most damage and we're going to lose the ship. But we still have a kick left. We're going to try to use it. I'm hoping that playing dead and the fire will bring the enemy to the surface. Except for securing crew and the gun crew of Mount 31, I want all of you to abandon ship. Repeat, abandon ship. Get as far away as quickly as you can.
It's possible the enemy will put another fish into us without warning. Now get going. Good luck. Steady keel.
Yavo.
We torpedo on the surface. Take it up.
Surface!
Submarine blowing tanks off starboard bow.
This side. I'm half surprised he took the bait. That's the first foolish thing he's done. Well, that makes us even.
Tell him that in 5 minutes I will finish off his ship.
Mm-hmm.
Capitaine!
He's given us 5 minutes. Signalman, take this message. Say message understood. And a thank you. Pound 31, this is the captain.
That sub will come close to beam. As soon as he's broadside, give him a shell in the stern.
If we're lucky, we ought to have a sitting duck. Your second target is his deck gun, but you better be quick, because he'll start shooting when we do. When I give the command to fire, continue at will. Signalman, no point in you and the talker staying aboard any longer.
Aye, aye, sir. Good luck, sir.
Good luck, sir.
Mr. Ware, your papers say that you were captain of a racing yacht before the war. You ought to have a pretty good eye for speed and distance over the water.
I think I have, sir.
Would you like to take the helm?
My pleasure, Captain.
This will not take long. You use only one torpedo, Schwaffer.
Captain.
Engine room, this is the captain. Can I still depend on you?
Just say the word, Captain. I'll give you all we've got.
Engine room. Crack your throttle wide and get the hell out of there.
Turn it on full and get out of here.
Aye, sir. Automatic detonators are set, Captain.
Get all aboard.
Sir, they're both laying off stern for us.
Right behind you.
Aye, aye, sir.
boat and close it. The captain's behind me.
The captain's still aboard. There on the deck.
We gotta give him some help. Get in there.
Those U-boats have detonators.
I don't care what they have. Take this boat in. Now.
Side, we go over that way. You understand English? Port side.
Not much time. You go. I bring this man.
Can't you see this man's dying?
He's my friend.
Sir, I'm double parked downstairs.
Nachdem es Gott, dem Allmächtigen, nach seinem unerforschlichen Ratschluss gefallen hat, unseren Kameraden Heini Schwaffer zu sein Vaterland sterben zu lassen, ein Leben voll treuer Pflichterfüllung, ein himmlisches Vaterhaus aufzunehmen, ist es unsere traurige Pflicht, den geliebten Kameraden hier auf hoher See den Wogen des Meers zu übergeben. Stillgestanden. Leb wohl, Heini.
Mannschaft, wegtreten.
Remember our talk on the bridge, the weighty one, death and destruction? You might be interested to know that I've seen another reason for hope. Found it in a funny place, too. In the middle of an ocean. Right in the middle of a war.
You had to come a long way to find it, though, didn't you, Doc?
It was worth the trip.
Maybe.
Died many times, Captain. But I continue to survive somehow. This time it was your fault.
I didn't know. Next time I won't throw you the rope.
I think you will.